Hi everyone, welcome back to the Western Centurion channel. This is my second attempt at this video because after the first one, after 20 minutes it took, I went to stop the video recording and found out the battery had gone flat, so it had already stopped. So I've had to redo it again. But first of all, thank you everyone for all your birthday wishes yesterday and this morning as well. It was absolutely fabulous. Really lovely of you all, so thank you very much for that. And before I get on to yesterday and my birthday, what Debbie and I went out and did, I want to know if any of you are or know anything about the paranormal or believe in the paranormal, because yesterday morning something really strange happened here in this garage, something that gave me the heebie-jeebies anyway. Because on Friday, on the, I don't know what you call it, well, table where the computer's on anyway, I left a cocktail stick that was broken in half. It was just something I found whilst I was tidying up the garage. When I came down yesterday morning to see if my video had finished uploading, that cocktail stick was in four pieces and arranged in a letter. It was either the letter M or the letter W, depending which way around you look at it. Now, I didn't do it, Debbie didn't do it, and a pretty certain poppy old cat didn't do it. Though if she did, that would have been an amazing video. But no, I'm certain she didn't do it. And that did give me the heebie-jeebies. Got no idea how that happened. Then I found out, when I went to put the password into my computer, that it was already full of digits. Obviously, I don't know what digits, but it was full of digits. So I had to delete all of those before I could put my own password in. Then when the desktop came up, Google Chrome was closed. Now, I use Google Chrome all the time, and that's what I use to upload the videos onto YouTube. And it was closed down. Now, I didn't close it down. I'd left it up, obviously, for the video to upload. So I didn't know if the video had uploaded or not, and I got no idea why it did it. The computer wasn't asleep. It was still running. And where did all those digits come from on there? Now where did that little M come from? Or how did the other two pieces of the cocktail stick break and magically arrange themselves into what appears to be a letter? It might not be a letter, it might be something else, or it might be some weird Greek or Gothic letter, but it's so bizarre. And that is the honest truth, and none of it's got anything to do with alcohol, because I was pretty good yesterday, to be honest. Which is just as well, because I was up at one this morning really ill. So yeah, I've been up since one this morning, and feeling a bit shattered. And at 12 o'clock Debbie and I are going out with the mum and dad for lunch, so I've got to really try and stay awake whilst you're out there. But anyway, enough of all that. Let's get back to yesterday. We had a brilliant day. Debbie took me to the Model Railway Exhibition, or the Swindon Model Railway Exhibition at the Steam Museum. We had a lovely couple of hours there. I took some videos of some of the layouts, or at least the layouts we could get into to see. I'll do a separate video of those for you because I want to try and keep this down to 15 minutes. and we went off and we sat down to have a coffee and saw Pete Waterman coming to the restaurant area, or the cafeteria area. And he sort of walked through, out one of the doors and down the side to go and have a look at the traction engines that were there. And I thought, oh God, my camera, or got my phone out with the camera on, but I missed him by then. So I put my phone away, finished getting my coffee, and I was on the way back to the table when he came back in again. So I quickly put my cup down on the table, tried to get my phone out, boom, he'd gone. He can't walk fast, that man, I'll tell you. But yeah, so saw Peter Waterman, obviously famous for his massive O-gauge layout. I think he's famous for something else as well, but I can't remember what that is at the moment. But yeah, he's famous for his O-gauge. Absolutely fabulous. And then we went to one of the stores. As I think one of the things that's happening now is that every year we'll go to the Swindon Model Railway Exhibition, and Debbie will buy me my birthday present there, which will be a loco. So just before we sat down for the coffee, Debbie picked up this loco and showed it to me. And nothing sort of clicked at the time when she did that. I looked at it and all I said to her, as a bit of a dork I am, I said, oh no, that won't fit the era of the layout. And then afterwards I thought to myself, what am I on about? I'm not bothered about the eras. I know I probably want to base it around the 60s and the 50s, 60s, 70s, around there somewhere. But I can run anything on it. And she really liked it. It's one that she picked out. But anyways, that was before we had a coffee. So when I'm having the coffee and I was sort of thinking, it was a really nice looking loco. And then it occurred to me, it was pretty much in the same place on the store where the Class 52 Western Centurion was. So I said, come on, quick, finish your coffee. So when we went back in, it was still there. I was relieved because I thought someone might have picked it up and bought it, because it was a good price as well. So I picked it up, had another look at it, and I thought, yeah, that's it. That is the present. So she said, okay, we'll buy that. And then she said, what else was it you were looking at? Because you had something else in mind, didn't you? And I said, well, yeah, there was something else. In fact, there's two things. So she said, oh, what were they then? So I pointed them out, and she had asked the bloke behind the counter if he could get them, because they're in boxes, if he could get them down. So he got them down, and she had a look inside. And she said, I like this one. And that was it. So she bought me two locos. How brilliant was that? I got two presents yesterday. Got no blinking layout to run them on, but I got two presents. And I'm going to show you them now. Ready? Here's the first one. Yes. Class 66. Never thought I'd end up owning one of these, but this one is very, very special in a sense. What's on the cover is not actually what's in the box. It is a Class 66. Park it out the box, alright? Hang on a minute. You ready? Ta-da! Stobart Rail. Absolutely stunning. Now, I'm not going to take it out of the packaging, because I'm going to do a separate video or a review and a little running session with her. But first impressions, she really, really is beautiful. And she's named Eddie the Engine. Beautiful. So that was the first one, and this is the one that was in the, I'm pretty certain, the exact same position as the Class 52 Western Centurion was last year. It's got to be an omen. And I'm so glad we bought it, because it is beautiful. So that was the first one. And the second one. Ta-da! Look at that then. Ambulance train number 40. Train set. Absolutely beautiful. Again, I won't take it out of the packaging. You can just see as it is at the moment, and I'll do another review on her. Something I wanted for quite a while, but couldn't warrant buying. So David bought this for my birthday as well. Am I a lucky chappy or what? I really, really feel a lucky chappy. That's those two. Then I just had this. Now, Debbie's mum and dad, in their birthday card for me, was a £10 note. And I spoke to them yesterday morning, I spoke to Debbie's mum yesterday morning, and she said that I had to spend it on something to keep, i.e., not spend it on drink not spend it on the taxi on the way to the exhibition. But I had to buy something with it, so I said that I'd buy something for the railway. And this is it. It's an ale wagon. So I couldn't buy real ale with it, but I could buy a wagon that carries ale. And I absolutely love it. And at £8.50, I think that's a damn good price, to be honest. So later on, I'll look at maybe buying some more. Maybe about four or five, so we can have six together. So yeah, that was my presents. So lucky, because I did not expect to get all of this, especially after that 9F incident. But it seems to be all in the past now, thankfully. So yeah, I'm really, really chuffed and over the moon with those. Right, so what I'll do as well, I'll make, and after this video, I'll make another video of our day in Swindon. It'll obviously include some of the layouts that we saw, pictures of us in there. But also, they had some things in the town centre. One was a replica of a Spitfire, full size. It was alright, a bit naff, you could tell it was a replica, but well done on them for even trying that. And some old classic cars and buses. So I took photographs of those, and there's one particular MG that we got chatting to the owner, and we managed to convince him to start it up, and it sounded beautiful. So I'll add that video as well. Alright, so what is one other thing? Ah, yes. I'll give a little shout out to Solomon. Now his channel is Life After Work. God, I hope I've got that right now. Yeah, Life After Work. He's done his first video and it's brilliant. It really is. He shows you what he's done to his garden since he retired from work. And it is fabulous. He's done so much. And that's, if I thought the garage was a big project, wait until you see what he's done. And he has... He has a barbecue stroke grill and a pizza oven. And it's like a big outside man cave, really, with all that in. It looks like about the size of this garage, but it's brilliant. Go take a look for yourself. And I'm certain that if we keep on at him, he will put a garden railway in, because he's certainly got the garden for it, and that will be amazing. So yeah, go and visit Solomon on Life After Work channel and just see what he's done and comment. It's absolutely brilliant, and he's a lovely chap as well. All right, so yeah, thank you very much. I'll be off to lunch soon, and I hope you all look forward to the next couple of videos and the reviews I'll do on my new presents. Although my reviews aren't really that brilliant, but I'll try my best and improve. Practice makes perfect, as they say. So, thank you very much. Have a lovely day, and see you again sometime. Bye.